his 1996 Rookie of the Year campaign. Then on April 9th, when the Yankees came home for their home opener, another young Yankee, a lucky by the name, for the Yankees, but on the final day of the month, with the help of a massive home run onto Utah Street in Baltimore from Paul O'Neill. The Yankees got the first place, and they did not trail in the division again that year.
With the beginning of May, we started to see what a memorable season this might become. Still in Baltimore on May 1st, the Yankees played a wacky 15-inning game that seemed like it would go on forever until Tino Martinez hit an opposite field grand slam, the victory and brought to win for the Yankee fans that were still missing John Madden. Then on May 14th was one of those magical nights that always seemed to come out of nowhere in Yankee Stadium. With his father in a Tampa hospital, waiting heart surgery the next day, White couldn't touch the mound with a lot on his mind. However, he wouldn't let that affect him as he pitched the ninth no-hitter in Yankee history against one of the most dangerous lineups in baseball.
Well, the Yankees went to the All-Star break with a 6-game lead on the Orioles, but were starting the second half with a crucial 4-game series in Baltimore. So what did they do? They swept the 4-game series and extended their lead to 10 games and looked like they were on a smooth ride to the division round. But the Orioles would not go away, so Bob Watson made a few trades, including bringing in Cecil Fielder to bolster the line. Earlier in the season, Dave Cone had surgery to repair an aneurysm in his pitching arm, and the Yankees weren't sure if he would pitch again that season. But on September 2nd, he came on the DL to pitch 7 no-hit innings to help restore the Yankees' confidence.
Baltimore had cut the Yankees' lead down to 3 games when they came to Yankee Stadium on September 18th. But Bernie Williams would tie the game in the bottom of the ninth. To help the Yankees all but end the pennant race.
Which all led to the first game of the double header on September 25th against the Milwaukee Brewers. Let us now turn our attention to the video board in center field as we take a look back on how that game ended and the Yankees' magical run to their 23rd World Championship.
Thank you. the opposite way. It could be trouble. It gets down and swung, comes off before it gets to the wall. That's a huge play. Because Williams has to stop the third on the double. When Martinez on the ball crosses the lane, Williams sprints to the point and scores. A long pitch to Fielder. And now he drives one a deep left. Way back. And done. And this ball.
Opportunities on for Andy Pettit. Again, the two-strike breakout.